Galchenyuk. Cole is at the side of the net battling Strawman. Subban down low. Bouillon. Pass blocked by Strawman. Bouillon to Subban. That was a pass. A lot of passes. They score. Looked like it was deflected in front. But a power play goal gives Montreal a 3-0 lead.
Yeah, Sam, I agree with you. I think it hit Strawman and deflected in through Marty Biron. But this is just quick passing by Montreal. Rangers are running a little bit. Even Gilroy now has to kill penalties. And they just keep moving it. Just keep moving it. Keep control. Move it and eventually just get it to the front of the net. Look at the quick passing. And I think it hits Strawman and deflects in. But that's what Michel Therrien was telling us the other day about their power play, about moving the puck and getting shots to the net. They had a great start to the season on the power play. They've struggled as of late. And he said it all comes down to just getting more shots to the net. That's a good example.
Well, Montreal has tightened up defensively on the Rangers, not giving them much in the second period, and they've taken advantage of the offensive opportunities. They've given Lars Eller credit for the goal. So what a night Lars Eller is having, with a goal and two assists. Final seconds of the second period, and a big second period for Montreal. Thrust in deep center. And a quick shot by Platen. It's a save by Biron as the second period comes to an end. Rangers have to go into the locker room and regroup. Things started to fall apart as Montreal scores three goals in the second, and they lead 3-0.
I think what happened, Sam, is that Montreal came out, and after a talk in the first, they played much better defensively. They seemed to control the pace of the second period, where I thought the Rangers controlled the pace in the first period.
Coming up, it's the New York Lottery Intermission Report. John Gianone rejoins us. He'll be outside the Canadiens locker room with a special guest. Ron Duguay is back in the studio with his analysis with Bill Pito, and Bill Pito has the Audi MSG 150. It's all coming up on the New York Lottery Intermission Report. Canadiens take advantage of opportunities and score three goals in the second period. And at the end of two, it's 3-0 Montreal.